before we create the pocket for the laser, we need to create an artboard equal to the size of the working area of your laser. Mine is 18 by 12. You go over here and click on the artboard tool. Okay. And just draw it there. And then we have to adjust the size. Usually the workspace, I like to select workspace essentials classic. That will give me some more controls. For example, here I can change the artboard size, change the width to 18 inch. Make sure this is off so when I click on the height, it doesn't change the width again.
Vincent, you are recording, right?
Yes, I am.
Okay, perfect.
Okay, so, oops. What happened was I changed it from the center, and so it created an artboard that overlapped the other one. So now I have to fix that problem by getting out of there. Let's get back in. Let's move this guy. There you go. It's no longer overlap. Just move this over here. So this artwork has been rounded to the laser diameter already. Now, if we want to make a pocket, what I would want to do is, assuming that the background will be on a solid wooden block of some sort instead of a piece of veneer, then I would copy the background. Before I do that, I have to create another artboard for the background. So let's do that. Something equal to the original artboard size. Click it, hold down the Alt key, and then drag. Now release the mouse before you release the Alt key. What that does is it copy and drag at the same operation. Okay. So now I can right click and release compound path. Okay, and I want to delete that oval and keep only the outline of the flowers and the leaves. So this is the path that I want to create a pocket from. So let's go over to the laser panel. Let's put it over here. So I select the path I want to create the pocket from. Then I go over here and I want to select artboard number 2. That's where I want the pocket to be placed on because that's my laser, okay? So I go and select artboard number 2 and then select smart pocketing. As soon as you do that, you know the laser curve is now negative because we want it to be smaller by the laser curve. And then we don't want to mirror cutter. The smart pocketing job automatically uncheck the mirror cutter because we don't want to mirror the pocket. We do want to mirror the smart profile. So when you select smart profile, it automatically select mirror cutters. You can always uncheck it. For profiling, we want to mirror the cutters. So let's go back to smart pocketing. Right, and then just click this create cutter path. There we go. Notice this rectangle is actually equal to the artboard size, artboard number 3, the size of artboard number 3. This rectangle is not actually a path, so when we send it to the laser, it won't see it. It is actually called a guide path. A guide path will never get sent to the laser. Okay, it's only there for alignment. For example, if I want to export it to DXF, for example, then that rectangle would be exported. And then you can select the whole thing and move it wherever you want. Okay, does that make sense? So the rectangle, assuming the rectangle here is actually a wooden block. So when you move the rectangle, you actually move the wooden block. at certain places. And in this case, we can move it everywhere we want. When you place the wooden onto the laser bed, you want to place exactly at location 0.95 on the axis and on the y-axis 1.25 inch, okay? So if you move this, you notice the x and y coordinates of that corner changes. Okay, so my laser upper left corner would be 0, 0, okay? And from, so the x-axis, the corner is at 0.52 and y is 0.48. So that's where you want to place the block at on the laser to match what you have on the screen. Otherwise, it will not laser correctly at the right location. Normally, you want to turn on ruler. Okay, show video ruler. Display the X and Y ruler. Okay, and I also like to turn on the grid. Show grid. Okay. Then I want to make sure that I have the grid at the setting I want. So I want to go to preference. Guides and grid. Guides and grid. You know, for imperial unit, let's make 1 inch per grid line and subdivision 2. Okay. So each subdivision is half an inch. Now let's see if we can align the artboard to the grid line. So let's click on the artboard tool. Let's turn on Smart Guide. Now we see if we can snap to the grid. Okay. Now, if we select the whole thing and we move it, it will. Which, well, hold on. I have to turn off the Smart Guide. The Smart Guide will snap to everything that it sees, and this can be confusing for the software because we only want to snap to the grid. Okay, and we do have to turn it off. So we did turn the Smart Guide off. We want to snap to grid on. Okay. Now, what if we move this point? It's going to snap to the grid. Let's zoom in and see what the cutter path look like. What we see here is a group of paths. And the field, the inner path is filled with a blue color. Now, if you look over here, the blue color, if your laser supports color coding, it should take the blue as being power of 10 and speed of 25%. Okay. If it doesn't, then you just manually get your laser to power 10 and speed 25. So the solid field is going to be raster. That's how the laser works. It look at the field path and it's going to do rastering. And then we have three additional lines on the outer edges. Those will be cutting paths. So your laser will have to be set to both cutting and rastering. The reason we have additional cutting paths, the three additional cutting paths, this allows a more accurate pocket. If the laser just do the rastering, it's going to go back and forth like this, right? It's going to go back and forth. And so the edges, if we don't have the cutting path and we have just the rastering path, it's going to go back and forth. The end result is going to be a little larger because it's going to come back and it's going to burn more. Every time it's coming back to do the rastering, it's going to burn a little bit more. And so on this side and this side, you're going to see it's going to be a little bit wider. That's why we prevent the rastering from touching our actual edges by doing the cutting first. Okay, we're going to cut down to the depth of the veneer thickness, and then we do the rastering. So the rastering actually does not touch the outer edge, so the resulting pocket would be a lot more accurate. Okay, so we're ready to send to the laser, and since I have Epiloc Mini 18, I just select print. And if we look over here, there's a number two here. That's the artboard number, okay? And the artboard name is artboard two. You can change artboard name to anything you want, but the artboard number stays the same. And this number is the one that we want to tell the print dialog that we want to print from that artboard number. In this case, we want to print from artboard number two, so I'm going to go ahead and select range, artboard range, and type in number two. Okay. Otherwise, when you click all, it's going to send every artboard to the laser. So we want to limit only to artboard two. Defined by driver, you need to have that for an Epiloc laser, and most other laser require that as well, because your laser would provide a driver, and you want the laser driver to have control. Placement centered, printing layer visible and printable layer only. Select your laser, Epiloc engraver, preference, and that will bring up the, since we're doing a pocket, and the pocket require both rastering and vector, so it's click combine. This is going to do both. It does the raster when it sees the path that has field color, and it will do the vector cutting when the path is non-filled and the line width is 0.001 pixel. We have to change the laser working area. Okay, so you don't want to enter anything other than your working area here, otherwise you're going to get really erroneous print. So the rastering, I would set it to 100%, and my power, I usually set it to around 20. I'm sorry, the power is going to be maximum, and the speed is going to be around 20%. Okay. And the resolution, I think 400 would be good for a pocket. So we have our raster setting, and then we're going to go to the vector setting. And the vector, based on the material, assuming that we have walnut being our material, then we want to set it to 10%. Power is 10%, and the speed is 25%. Okay, notice here is Epiloc never actually update the laser to work correctly with Illustrator. So as soon as I click the print button and I look over here, the artboard is not really displayed correctly. It should be 18 by 12, but it doesn't look like it's 18 by 12. It looks like it's a square. To fix this, I just click the setup again and then click print again. Now it is the rectangle, and this is the correct artboard that we want. That's it.
So Vince, that's the pocket part, but and that's where I think our next step was. But is the software pretty explanatory as far as how to add images to your artwork from your veneers that's on your computer?
So let's open the images panel. Okay. If you look down here, this is the this is called the image folder. That's where you have to specify to tell ImagePaint where you want it to manage all your images. Okay. You need to do this only once for all projects. you know, assume I'm a new user and I want to start everything from scratch, I would go and select set image folder, the first thing we want to do. And I'm going to create some new folder here for us to use. I call test images. Okay. As soon as you do that, you see this? It print out the location of the image folder, and you can click it to open it. Okay, assume now that you have your scanned images in some folder and you want to bring it into test images folder. At the same time, you want to bring all those images into the images panel. You need to specify where your scanned images are, and you can do that by selecting add images in folder. Okay, and that will open a dialog. And I'm going to go to a folder that were created when I install ImagePaint. And you can go to C, Program Files, Amazon Canvas. Okay, that is the folder that were created shortly after you install ImagePaint. And then you double-click ImagePaint, and let's see, image library. No, it should be in sample. And then test images, okay? So these test images, and then I just click select folder. And we look over here, all the images have been added to the images panel. Okay, let's go to the image folder that we created. It was empty. Okay, now it created the subfolder. Okay, 13 of them based on the number of new wood species JPEG images that we selected that were in that folder. And if you double click and you open it, and there was one. Okay. I hope that makes sense. Let's go to let's go back to the folder that contain the scanned images. Go to Program File, Amazon Canvas, Image Paint, Sample. Yeah. So these are the scanned images. So Image Paint took all these images and add them to the images panel, and at the same time add them to the image folder that we create. So now if we save this file and next time we open it, all these images will be loaded because it does remember the images that were in the images panel. It will reload all the images for you. And you can also select the images that are in the images panel using this lookup box. Okay. As you can see, when you click and select from that lookup box, you can see the image swatch being selected via this highlight, the rectangle, okay? Or you can directly select it by clicking on the image swatch itself, okay? Of course, now we can paint any path with any image by clicking on the image swatch, as you can see over here. And that's it.